Welcome back, everyone. In part one of the clock reaction experiment, I discussed how to calculate the rate of a reaction using the clock reagent method. In this video, we will discuss how temperature and catalyst play a role in regulating the rate of a chemical reaction. In part two of the experiment, you will use the Arrhenius equation that you learn in class to help you determine the value of the activation energy and frequency factor for the target reaction shown below. I will briefly review the Arrhenius equation before showing you how to use it in this part of the experiment. Recall that the collision theory is the concept that helps us understand the factors that determine the rate or speed of a chemical reaction. The concepts in collision theory can be broken down to 1. That reactants must collide with each other to make products. 2. That the rate of a chemical reaction is proportional to the number of those collisions. And 3. That to generate products, the collisions must satisfy the following requirements. A.
The collision must generate enough energy to break the bonds in the reactant.
This energy is called the activation energy, with symbol E sub A, of the reaction. B, the reactants must be oriented correctly so that the necessary chemical bonds can be broken in the reactants. This orientation component is called
the frequency factor,
with symbol A. These factors are then combined together mathematically in the Arrhenius equation, which shows how the rate constant K depends on A, the frequency factor, times E to the power of the activation energy over RT, where RT in this case functions as a measure of thermal energy of the molecules. You can linearize the Arrhenius equation and write it as ln of k
equals to
negative Ea over r times 1 over t plus ln of a. The plot of these two forms of the equation are shown below. Now, the reason we use the linear form is because we can easily fit the plot to a line equation. We can see from the linear form of the equation that the slope of the line is just equal to negative Ea over r, while the y-intercept is equal to ln of a. That allows us to solve for both Ea and a if we can fit the linear form of the plot. For example, let's say we take the data I just showed you and fit it with a line equation and get y equals minus 12,174 times x plus 30.694. If the unit of the slope is Kelvin, how do we calculate Ea and A? The slope can be used to determine Ea. Since slope is negative Ea over r, then Ea should equal negative slope times r. Plugging 8.314 joules per mole Kelvin for r, we should get Ea equals to 101 kilojoules per mole for this reaction. Next, the y-intercept can be used to solve for A, the frequency factor. Y-intercept is equal to 30.694, which is equal to ln of A. So A is equal to E to the power of 30.694, which is just 2.14 times 10 to 13 per second. To obtain the plot that I showed you, you will need to measure the rate of the reaction at various temperatures. This will be one of the experiments you will perform during the lab. Lastly, the third goal of today's lab is to observe the effect of adding a catalyst to the rate of our target reaction. You will record the time it takes the reaction to take place with the addition of a molybdate catalyst.